You got it?
George, you were going to dress as Tootsie for this meeting. You're here to discuss the issues that many of you raised in the February 3rd letter, and we want to reiterate our commitment with ensuring legal and economic equity for women. And we welcome Elizabeth Dole back today to participate in this meeting, since she worked so hard on women's equity and so long. Faith can't be with us today. She's ill. And so Elizabeth is back here to help out because she's been familiar with all that is going on virtually at the present. And on this subject, and we're pleased, of course, Secretary of HHS, Margaret Hackler here, and Ed, both of us, Ed Harper and Ed Schmaltz, here to participate in this important discussion. We hope that everybody involved here today will be able to work together to solve very real problems and continue to confront women. Hope that together we can forge a public working ground in which to resolve these issues. Contrary to many reports, this administration, I think we'll find out before the day's over, has been aggressively pursuing the development of policies that do just that. We want to hear from you, however, about what more can be done and should be done, but we also want you to know what's already been done. For example, the Economic Recovery Tax Act, as you know, increased child care credits. It also provided incentives for the private sector child care, and it raised the estate tax exemption. And we'll wipe that out completely for whichever spouse becomes the heir or heiress. That will be down the road a little ways in the program we passed. All of these proposals were contained in the Women's Economic Equity Act, introduced in the 97th Congress and was subsequently enacted in the Economic Recovery and Tax Act. The Title III of the Job Training Partnership Act provides substantial retraining of displaced homemakers. As a matter of fact, our fiscal year budget request asked for an increase of 10 times what has been spent in that regard, and that will be from $25 million going up to $240 million for this program. We can always do better. We realize that our administration and Republicans in general have a perception problem with American women. And I think it's as disturbing to me as it is to all of you. However, we hope that working together, we will be able to address and alleviate problems that are real and problems that are based on misinformation and misunderstanding. And I'm not going to go on talking anymore. I'm going to turn the meeting over to Elizabeth, who's conducting so many meetings on subjects of this kind.
Thank you, Mr. President. Well, it's a real honor for me to have a chance to meet with this group this morning and to chair this session, because as your Assistant for Public Liaison and Chair of your Coordinating Council on Women, I had an opportunity to meet with the women who are here this morning, both as a group on Capitol Hill, and then also I've met with a number of you, of course, individually, as we have pursued these issues of mutual concern. And I know this group, Mr. President, to be anxious to work with us in both focusing on and highlighting the problems that women have today, a very changed situation with the great numbers of women who've entered the marketplace, entered the workforce recently. We have a new set of problems that we're faced with, and they are anxious to work with us in identifying those problems and finding the answers to them. So I'm just delighted to welcome each of you today to the White House. In the time that we have,
just confirmed something that I feel about Congress in general, on meetings and all, and I don't mean any disrespect to this, but every time we have a congressional, a meeting with congressional personnel down here, we wind up behind with the schedule for the rest of the day. So he's staying over there and I came over here. And are we having a press opportunity in here?
Yes, we are.
Well, we left a small talk for a minute or two.
Yeah.
I guess you paid for the mic, no?
And then two lights, right?
I think we should have to leave where we are.
Francisco Egan, running out of Michigan.
George Martinez, Albuquerque, New Mexico.
Steve Diaz from San Francisco.
Pepe Mendez, Denver.
Lilia Laza from New York.
Santo Rivera from the great state of Florida.
Doctora Garcia Fonseca from New York.
Steve Tarasino from New York.
George Adams, California, Los Angeles. Pablo Gomez from Miami, Florida. Patrick Cipino, Miami, Michigan.
Raymond Cantara, Puerto Rico, Mr. President.
Eva Flatoranas, New York.
Rafael Mala, Fort Church, Virginia.
Dr. Luis Geral, Maryland.
Diaz Carlo, New York City, New York, Empire State.
Mario Aguero from Big Apple, New York.
Luis Hernandez, San Antonio, Texas.
Daniel Gonzalez, New York.
My big president, Octavio Alfonso, the New Jersey State. Okay?
Mr. President, Richard O'Hara from San Antonio, Texas.
District of Columbia.
Espain Lopez, Massachusetts.
Gladys
Rivera,
New York.
Okay, both of them.
Valcelli, Puerto Rico.
These means are the permanent of different states that we have all the patients. The office of Poland's Republican Medical Center.
Well, it is mine, and I want to express my thanks to the help that you have been in greater numbers than in the past. We're grateful for this, and we want to address the problems that, that you may have, both personal and policy. Here. So we can't talk much further.
Mr. President, how do you view the Soviet Union's comment that your speech was bellicose last night?
I can't take questions on the photo. You expect them to cheer.
Beautiful.
Mr. De Junco, I wonder if the Hispanic are united in support of the president program now more than ever.
We love the president.
Why don't you see?
We love the president.
Well, I think it's very important to bring that question up because, Mr. President, we have discussed your policies in South America and Central America and so on, and this group unanimously endorses your policy. And if you have anything we can do for to help you, we'll be ready.
We can do that.
We love you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Certainly use that kind of help because we have not progressed as fast as we want to with the Caribbean Initiative and with regard to our friends in Central America. in the Congress. And we need, as I've said about the Congress, it isn't necessary to make them see the light, you just have to make them feel the heat. Said in here, I didn't mind if they heard that. We are grateful to you and the few minutes that we, that I have here, I want to hear from you, because I have always believed, having been a Democrat for most of my life, until I saw the light, became a Republican, I have always believed that all of you had a lot more in common with the Republican philosophy than you do with the philosophy of the other party. And our problem is getting the message to the people, getting the message of what it is we represent, what we understand. And this is the subject of the meeting in the other room where George still is also, that same thing about perception on the part of the people of somehow there is a reluctance to believe that the Republican Party, or there's a tendency to believe that if you're not on the first tee of the Burning Hill Country Club, we're not interested in you. Well, I've never been on the first tee. Yes, the speaker's there all. As a matter of fact, every once in a while when I see him, Tip tells me, going down to make a speech in Florida, wherever it might be. And I say, and I'll bet there's a golf tournament down there. Yes, there is.
President, is it true that Honduras forces have invaded the Nicaraguan yesterday?
No, it is true, though, not to any news that I have at all, and I think I have it first. No, it is true that out of the revolution in Nicaragua, this was the usual thing that we've seen before. Years ago, we saw it in Laos, and it was a democratic administration, you remember, that made the Laotian government take the Pathet Lao, the guerrillas, and deal with them into a kind of combine, a government in partnership. And the government automatically became the Pathet Lao. Well, in the revolution against Somoza in Nicaragua, there were, yes, Matthew Huston. Nice to see you,
Daddy. Ron Houston. Nice to meet you.
How are you?
Well,
this
is, well, this is Mr. Smith, the president of the Easter Seal. John Garrison, the section of radio.
This is very nice to meet you. I appreciate you taking the time to see us.
Mr. President, this is John Bicon.
How do you do?
Faith Witnesses, Deputy Attorney. This is his first White House,
the law office of pressure.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. I think they really want to do it all much. I'm very honored to have that. I know that this is 64 years and 800,000 volunteers in the cause of Easter Seals.
These
are for
my school, and all the people,
mm-hmm.
The principal, Mr.
Allen,
and everybody at the school
wanted to be here. Well, thank you very much. Matthew. Well, would you please convey to them my thanks? And I know that you're going to be on the telethon. A friend of mine, Pat Tolman, is hosting a quality telethon, and please give him my regards. What is that slogan for this year?
Can you turn it around there?
No. 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 No
good.
Thank you very much. I'm pleased to have that.
Did you meet Mr. Goldman?
Yes.
Yeah.
I can't respond to that. Yeah.
I know. I'm just.
Yes.
We're satisfied with it.
Thank you.
That was my question.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.